Hello, this is Captain Poodle speaking. Are you ready to find love?
Yes, ahoy, matey.
Love.
Do, 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 do.
Exciting and new. Go online. They're catfishing you.
Shocker.
Fiance.
Soon you'll be flying to parts unknown.
90-day Beyonce.
Marrying someone you only met on your phone.
Be they French or Chinese, a brand new K-1 visa's the key.
Ooh, the key to what, Poodle?
To love.
It's reality, yay, let's love.
Guess what? Mama's got a boyfriend.
What, Mom? What's a boyfriend?
That's the guy you're gonna have sex with as much as you want, and he's gonna climax inside you.
Oh no, Mom! You're gonna do that again?
I sure am, Pee-wee.
Oh,
you're
Mom.
Gonna get all engorged again.
Oh no, that made me feel kind of funny. He's not gonna live with us, though, is he, Mom? I don't want to share you.
I may move up to Canada, Pee-wee.
Yeah, this isn't going to work out.
You'll freeze right off my face.
How do you kill a Canadian?
Y'all, Mother Debbie's in love.
Debbie. Debbie's in love.
I definitely think this is fast.
Yes, y'all, this is Single Life, Season 3, Episode 4. In the words of Mark Chestnut, all my old flames have new names. There's a lot of girls in town who tied the knot and settled down, and I thought I'd start a fire with some of my old flames, but they all got new names.
Wow, you know this whole song.
Oh, I love Mark Chestnut.
I remember him being hot. Am I wrong?
He was handsome. He was early 90s hot.
You know what? What I've noticed is if I think they're hot, that there's a certain good big dickness to him.
You know, I was going to say he has probably a big dick. He's got a prominent nose.
Yeah. I knew something even then.
But that was one of those good old country songs with a lot of fiddle, which I prefer. I love a lot of fiddle. But it's a kind that just, it's kind of like all my exes, George Strait.
Yeah.
It's going to list people whose names rhyme with different towns. And I have to say, I love those kind of songs.
They're well written.
Usually well written songs, yeah. You wrote a song like that once. What was it for? Cabaret or something.
Oh, about people's names that rhyme with something?
You did something like, I enjoy song about people and names having to rhyme. Cities and names having to rhyme. It just,
that's a very niche love, but go with it. Good for you. This is Single Life, as you said. Yeah, old flames and new names.
Yes.
I assume.
Tiffany.
Who has a new name?
Maybe Debbie. They're a title. Maybe a boyfriend?
Oh. Or Caesar. You know, we should not think too hard about these because
they're not good.
They don't.
They
the
don't.
The people who come up with them don't put so much thought into it.
Straight guy number three who names these.
Ugh. Y'all, good. Thank you for coming at me when I basically said that, I think I said that 60% of heterosexual men or straight men were boring.
People said more.
I've been corrected that it's more like 80%.
That's what people have said. That's what people have said.
If you're one woman went, hell, all of them are.
If you're a straight man who listens to this,
I'm sorry.
To this podcast, I think you're in the 20%.
Know that women.
I think you're more interesting.
Know that women are plotting your death.
It's like we had a straight male sissy at our Chicago show who just said, I really enjoy your show. And it was the best compliment. He does like water maintenance stuff like my, city water planning stuff like my brother. And, but he just said, I just listened to it, and it just was so stupid. And I went, that's the best compliment when people tell me that.
It makes
me feel good, and they laugh at the stupidity of it.
Well, I think it is stupid what we do. And
don't try to say it's highbrow.
It's not. No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying I think there's a there's a joy in that.
Oh, there's a joy. But there's a lot. We've been listening to our old episodes of Love is Blind because we are recording
2 years ago.
New intros.
2.5 years ago, actually.
New intros to season one of Love is Blind because we're releasing it from where, Poodle?
From the vault.
From the vault. We got to work on that noise. But anyway, y'all, so we're going to release all of season one, and then we're going to have to watch season or episode 10 and record it again because it didn't get recorded.
Crowdcast,
it was
fucked Crowdcast. Us.
So anyway, that's all coming out. Love is Blind season 3, which we have watched a little preview thanks to our partnership with Netflix.
It's very good.
Quite good.
Quite good.
Quite
we're excited.
Delicious.
It starts on October 19th. That's going to be on Reality Gaze Plus. You're going to know some changes in that, y'all. Reality Plus, we're kind of rebranding
still,
the art. It's going to look
Patreon,
a little different.
Still Supercast, but you can now get it on Apple subscriptions.
Not when you listen to this episode. Not up yet. We're hoping by October 19th.
Yes.
That's the goal.
Yes.
I'm worried. But the retrograde's over, so hopefully things move smoother. Anyway, y'all, come see us live on the Doublet Tour. Hey, if you like the single live, then we got a show for you.
It's our Tampa show. Our first night of the Tampa, our first Tampa night is we talking about single life. We'll be doing Happily Ever After as well, but the second half will be all single life.
Yes, and DC will talk about Love After Lockup and Happily Ever After as well.
Yes.
So, and we're supposed to, Deonte says he's coming.
Apparently he is.
We don't know.
Yeah.
We don't know, but he says he's going to come up.
He's being a little sketchy on Instagram.
He is. So we don't
but,
know.
But, you know, I shouldn't say anything because he listens to everything.
Yeah. I don't know if he listens to us because Love After Lockups is on the paywall.
That's true.
So y'all know none of them pay for that.
That's true.
We did that on purpose. So, could you imagine how much destiny would come for us if she
I'm scared.
To shit? Dude, I heard you.
She's just there like sticking a penknife in my door.
We don't need that. Anyway, I don't think any more announcements.
I think it's good.
Yeah, I think we're good. All right, let's jump in.
I think we're good. So y'all, Mother Debbie's in love. He says he's 100% compatible. She's like, so we're in a committed relationship. Apparently after 2 days, that's okay. I guess things move fast past 68.
Did they talk a lot before this?
They've been talking, yeah.
So maybe it's just the first time in person, really.
No, I agree.
It still seems quick. But you don't have a lot of time.
I mean, my
dad died at 71.
I guess that's true.
I mean, Debbie's got, if she's my father, she has a year. Why wait?
That's quite fatalistic.
Well,
she's got a year.
Yeah.
You know what? You got a point there.
That's true.
Maybe it's not fast.
It's not.
Let her make her mistakes.
Y'all, they're in the beautiful Venice canals at Caesar's Palace. We've all been there.
The authentic canals.
You know, Poodle can't ride on those anymore. And he signed a contract and is not allowed to tell you why. But he can't, just so you know.
There's very, 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 very specific clauses of what I can say.
And let's just say three men at Caesars lost their job that day.
But they found a calling.
Including a gondola driver. He got fired.
And a dog who watched.
Yeah.
The dog was never seen from again.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
So, just know that he's really into her.
Very.
And he asks her to come to Vancouver as well.
Yeah, I mean, they do ask good questions where he says, like, do you think we're compatible? Absolutely. And so,
absolutely.
And Tony says, I'm not going to be talking to anyone else.
Right.
And Debbie's like, so we're in a committed relationship. They have more discussions than a lot of other people do.
That's
on these
true.
Shows. And so when
it's better than Tania or Tanya just going, blah, blah, I think I'm divorced. I think I'm divorced. What about you?
That's
going
to flame out quickly.
Yeah.
We haven't seen a lot of her. We get her next episode, but we didn't have any of her last episode, did we?
Didn't have her a lot, yeah.
So
I think there are 10 episodes.
Debbie, I mean, well, yeah, but I honestly, y'all, it made my heart skip a beat a little bit when Debbie said, so I'm happy to say I have a boyfriend.
I know.
Like, that was... again, it is sweet to see someone in this part of her life who didn't think this was going to happen.
The airport later on, she says, I think I'm falling in love with you.
And he says, I'm falling in love too.
It was just like a country, weird version of like that lowered expectations thing that used to be on Mad TV.
I don't even know.
Expectations.
I've not seen that, but I would
enjoy
that.
It's like a dating thing that showed people that did personal ads, what they want. Sometimes they use characters from Mad TV, like Mrs. Swan did one, and Lowered Expectations was their kind of thing. It was very funny back in the day.
Oh, Mad TV, what a flashback.
If you are under 25, you don't have any idea what Mad TV is, but that's okay.
30.
Really?
Yeah, honey. 30.
Yeah. It was on in the 90s.
Yeah, 30, honey.
Fine.
So they kiss. They're making out again at the airport, falling in love. And I wrote, I am moved by this.
I wrote down exactly. I'm a little moved.
I am. So anyway.
It wasn't just because my antidepressants were wearing off.
Yeah, exactly. And it's like Debbie said. The last time someone told me they loved me was before my husband died.
No.
That broke my heart. And we should all hear that we're loved.
And she's scared about, I think Colt says that. I love you, Mom.
Yeah, but she's sick of
hearing
Colt.
That.
Yeah, it's Colt.
Probably her cats in her head say it. Yeah. Mr. Whiskers and Tom Tom.
Pee-wee says it all the time. Love you, Mom.
Along with,
love me back, Mom.
Along with Lola Brigida.
You'll never get rid of me, the Persian.
So... She admits she's scared about doing a long distance relationship.
Mm-hmm.
But you could always do a 90-day fiance.
She could.
Can you imagine?
The thing is, Vancouver to Vegas though is not a long flight.
No,
it's like 2.5 hours, I think, if that.
True.
Because LA to Vancouver, I think is 3.
Yeah. Yeah. Riveting.
Riveting. The weather's beautiful there. It's just a little gray.
The weather's nice in the summer.
You're gonna have to get a sad lamp.
You need a sad lamp, especially in the late fall.
But it's beautiful.
Yeah,
lots of trees.
Yeah, yeah. Gorgeous. A couple days have passed, and Mrs. Tony, and she's moving out of the house she's lived in for 4 years. She's moving in with her friend Audrey, and I think that's a good idea. But she's gonna meet Audrey and Marina, her friends. And the friends are saying, you know, we're so happy you're into this, but maybe you should be scared or cautious. You should slow down. She's like, why? I think I'm fine. Everywhere, you know. And then Audrey's like, I also should tell you, I have a dog, and he charges cats. And I don't want to hurt your cat, so sorry you can't live with me.
I feel like this should have been talked about before.
Me too.
Even Debbie says, she knows I'm not going anywhere with my cats.
Yeah.
That's got to be a hard sell, because how many cats does Debbie have now?
Like 6. I feel like...
I love cats. I do not want to live in a home with 6 cats.
I feel like this was a situation where they had had way too many sea breezes.
What is a sea breeze?
I don't know. But
I've never had
one. It sounds like something older women drink.
Maybe.
I can just see.
Does it have Fresca in it? Because I think Fresca
don't know.
Series C.
Why is Fresca the C?
I don't know. It just looks it.
I don't know why they're called sea breezes.
I don't know.
Oh, no. Now you're going to Google.
Hey, Siri, what's in a sea breeze drink?
Siri will know.
Oh, it's a cocktail with vodka, cranberry juice. I was close. Fresca has grapefruit juice in it, and a sea breeze is vodka, cranberry juice, and grapefruit juice.
Oh!
Can't drink it if you're on Lipitor.
Oh, grapefruit?
Yeah. I didn't know. I just learned this. Grapefruit cancels out some effectiveness of medications. So if you're on Lipitor, you're not supposed to drink grapefruit juice.
Wow, we're just churning them out today.
Well, you know, Debbie would be interested in that.
Didn't know you came here to get your medication conflicts, but I'm glad you did.
That's the power of grapefruit.
So for Lipitor takers, this show might have saved your life.
Maybe.
We need to move on. I just can't do this. It's a comedy show. It's a comedy show. Can I move on to Natalie?
Oh.
Okay.
Oh.
This was her at full mango.
Yeah.
This was, please. No, do not leave me. You cannot have me. Get away from me. Do not touch me.
You know, we've kind of been talking about this, and I even, like, went through some old books and, like, just to verify, but it is now...
Personality disorder.
It's now official. And people say, you shouldn't diagnose. I have enough evidence for this, and she 100% has bipolar, or not bipolar, borderline personality disorder.
Yeah, BPD.
Yeah, BPD, for sure, just because it so much is about... And I know that, too, because my grandmother had that. When I look back, yeah. I'm pretty sure my grandma Hazel had that. But the, and y'all can look at, and I say this because if you have someone in your life, you probably think, oh, they're just crazy, or I can never please them. I hope that you realize they have a personality disorder, and it's something they need help with,
yeah,
medication with. It's something you can't fix. Josh can't do anything with his arms to fix this.
He looks good in that t-shirt.
Oh, God, he looks so fucking good.
I would rip that off of him.
Oh, God. I just
want to lick him all over.
I just want to lick his... I bet it tastes like Bath and Body vanilla bean. Just sweet all over.
I don't want to taste Bath and Body Works.
Yeah. Yeah. But...
Wow.
Mainly with BPD, the main thing is fear of abandonment.
Yeah.
And that is what rules Natalie's life. That's the only reason why she wants a child. Because that child won't abandon her.
And a lot of people with personality disorders, borderline being a specific one, a lot of people think they're the life of the party because they're going to be kind of, there are a lot of different people in a lot of different circumstances.
Yeah.
And Natalie's friends would tell you she's a good time. She's quirky. I don't think she really has any friends.
I don't think it's hard with people that my
she
heart
scares
goes
them
out
away.
With people that have BPD, it's and you know it, and you're trying. It can be very difficult, especially to get on the right medication management and things like that. If you're listening, you have it.
It is manageable.
It is manageable. So we don't want to think that you, if you have to go, oh God, am I nuttily? You're not. You're not. It's manageable. But it can be very hard to make friends because you have these great friendships. And then when they do something that triggers your abandonment issue, you fly off the handle and go and just make them feel like Josh, who thought, what did I do? Am I the worst person in the world?
Y'all, so... Natalie, the other thing which you put with Natalie is you have some type of trauma that she experienced growing up had to be from her father.
Which I think probably led to, I mean, BPD a lot of times can be genetic, but yeah, that on top of it. And then the top that she, I don't know if it's a personality, but she's quite self-involved. There's just it's a very complex diagnosis with this one.
Yeah.
Whoa.
She is saying, I really wanted our morning to be romantic, but he has to work.
And he's like trying to like touch her and flirt with her. And she goes,
don't touch me.
Oh, no. And he literally just goes, oh, no. And she says, she's like, I just need more of him and I don't have it. She said, what did she say? When I sleep with someone, that means I want to have children with him. And I thought... How does that work for you, Poodle? Do you want to have children with him every time you sleep with
him? I might scream out, give me your baby juice.
Wow.
But I don't necessarily want to have children with them.
That actually made me gag.
Yeah, you did. You kind of...
just bile, just kind of caught up a little bit.
That's just something I say.
Okay.
I don't mean that every time I sleep with someone, I want to give them a child.
Okay.
I think for her, and she also says, I truly hoped he would commit and talk about child.
Yeah, she does say
again,
that.
Again, this is...
Third date.
The third time. And this is... I in my head, what confuses me of all this is, what does she want from him?
Well, the thing is it you can't because right. now we know it's a BPD issue.
I don't even think she knows.
There's not a rational
right.
She just wants someone to be with her all the time, and committed. So like, he can never have a job. Like
no.
Josh says, my 5-year-olds understand this, and Natalie doesn't. She literally is, and this is what broke her and Mike up.
Yeah,
Mike went to work.
That's
to pay
true.
For all this shit. And the worst thing you can do to someone who's going through is
she was left in the wood.
In the wood, alone.
She was left
in the
wood.
No wonder she went just.
She went with her lesbian friend.
Yes.
You have your meds. Like, you have your cat.
Wow.
Still one of my favorite theaters
wow.
ever. Was her.
Using the bathroom.
Her going to the bathroom.
Yeah, you really had a lot of Foley for that one.
Oh. So.
I feel not comfortable, honestly.
I don't like it.
I don't feel right. I give you my time. I come here.
You don't have time for me.
Isolated.
No, she said isolated.
Yeah, she did say isolated.
It's interesting.
Josh, she goes in his rant and Josh goes, I had a good time with you this week. He literally, this guy, y'all, this guy doesn't know what to say. And honestly, maybe because he's doing this because he's on television, but Josh could just go at her and say, you're crazy. You're a nut.
No, he
does not do that to her.
He's being pretty
like he's
understanding.
And actually acting as if he still cares for her.
At one point, he says, well, I made this time for you. And she goes, good, enjoy. Like, enjoy this time
She's
now.
She's quite mean to him,
yeah.
Honestly.
And she says, I put my effort into you. If you don't put your effort in for me, it's not going to happen.
No, exactly. And the producer says, what's going on, Josh? And Josh, it's a woman producer, but the Josh goes, I have no fucking idea, bro.
It is this kind of thing, because, y'all, she's written in her mind their story on their first date.
Oh.
That's how bad it
yeah.
is.
Yeah.
It's like she should write a manual on how to date, and you do the exact opposite.
Yeah, I guarantee you that this is why Natalie's been married three times.
Three times.
Yeah. Three
Mike
times.
Mike was the third husband.
And why, I mean, I know she talks about, it makes me, you know, she talks about, I think, what's her second marriage? Not violent, but it was.
I don't think she talks about the second one.
She has one marriage that, though she said she felt not safe or something.
Yeah.
She talked about it a little bit. I think another thing with somebody with BPD is they are self-sabotagers, so they ruin mm-hmm. it. So I'm not excusing like any violence or abuse, but I think this is going to be Natalie's pattern forever until she gets this under control. She's always going to ruin a relationship like this.
Oh, and it's only going to get worse.
And, the older she gets.
And sadly, people like Natalie can get preyed upon by men who will tell them what exactly what they want to hear.
Yeah.
So that's the scariest thing. Weirdly, she is adaptable and she is a creature of survival. Like,
yeah.
That's the most interesting thing about her. And she can be personable and she can be people with personality disorders like this can blend in. You can act like, but when something goes wrong, they will show their true colors. You will start
they
to
will.
See. Yeah,
they will.
The thing about it is, y'all, if you can be on the right meds and everything like this, you can pretty much live a regular life.
You really can't.
It
breaks my heart because probably Natalie sometimes feels like she's, quote, crazy.
Yeah.
When she doesn't realize it's more of a genetic, again, it often runs in families. So it's mm-hmm. literally how you're wired. It's your chemistry.
Right.
It's not your fault.
Well.
Poodle, this reminds me, by the way, it's time for you to call the doctor. We need to get you on some meds.
Oh, I'm already on a lot. I'm already on plenty. I need to up it, though. We're officially going on that tour. Maybe I'll tell my doctor, I'm going to take two a day.
Two a day.
It's like, no, you're not.
I will say, y'all, I do want to remind you that it is empirically proven that medicine always works best when you do it in addition, conjunction with
therapy. Yes.
So whether you use BetterHelp, which is our sponsor, one of our favorite sponsors, or you seek therapy yourself.
Or just talking to your friend Carlene every night.
No, maybe a real therapist. not Carlene.
I don't know. Carlene.
Carlene has pies to make. She does not need to hear your bullshit.
That's probably true. So at one point, he goes, she locks herself
in the bathroom.
And then he's like, so can we talk? She's like, I'm on the toilet. You can go by. It's very mango. This is all very mango. Like, you cannot have the mango.
Yeah.
and then she's like, so she's like, I'm peeing. I'm busy.
And he was like, okay, well, I guess I'm going to leave. And so he leaves, and that's where he goes back to his room, and he kind of says, like, my kids understand this. She wants me to be like this. I don't have a normal life. He said, you know, I've got my job. He said, I'm not 15 years old. I can't be with her. I've got things to do. And Natalie, meanwhile, is spinning and just kind of screaming at the producers in the room. She's basically saying, how could you do this? Bring me here. And all
he
that.
He could buy a ticket for me and I could go with him.
He fucking uses me.
This is magical thinking. That Natalie really believes a man who is reasonably sane would buy a ticket for her when he's going home to Arizona without arranging anything. He would just bring her and then just keep spending time.
I mean, magical thinking is a nice word for it. I would call it, it's delusional thinking, because it is completely not. Again, it's this idea, y'all, this is the third date and she's thinking this guy needs to commit to her like this.
Yeah. I don't think anyone thinks Natalie is is in the right here.
I hope people watch this, and y'all, if you see this in your life and this is you,
or you have
help,
a friend or relative,
it's not your job for them to get help. Yeah. Maybe bring it up, but it's okay if you sit yourself out of this relationship.
Exactly. And she even says, I don't think he's coming back. And
she's hurt now.
And then she moved on to hurt really quickly. He broke my heart, and I wrote down sobs and crazy.
She
like racking sobs on the bed, y'all.
Oh, yeah, knocking things off. Yeah, classic.
Yeah.
All right, everybody, we're gonna take a little break, but when we get back, we've got a new stater in town.
Shoulders McGee.
Whatever shoulders wants, shoulders gets. And little man, little shoulders, isn't sure what she wants at all.
No, she never has been.
Not at all. Not at all, bless her.
But it doesn't stop her from taking her kids wherever to...
I mean, I'm glad she's doing this, but we already... Y'all, it's Shoulders McGee. We're talking about Tiffany, who's 30. God,
is she only 30?
I wrote, Tiffany has lived many, many lives.
Well, remember, she had an I didn't know I was pregnant baby.
Yeah.
Daniel.
And then now she has, what's
Carly.
Her name? I almost said Bobby Christina.
I don't know. Oh, wow. Too soon.
Carly. And then with Ronald.
Ronald, have you heard of him? But trafficking my boy.
No, Dad.
Now, the potato-headed boar who lives in South Africa, who is South African, we've been all over the map with Tiffany. And so is she. And this is someone who I shouldn't say disappointment with her, is how she seems to repeat the exact same pattern over and over and over again.
Yeah, it's like, you know, a lot of these people will say, we enjoy watching them, but we'll say they're horrible. Like Kim and Usman are both horrible to one another.
Yeah.
Or things. Danielle Muhammad were horrible to one another.
Yeah.
I don't think Tiffany's a horrible person.
No,
she's
not.
We actually like her. She seems like
her life choices.
She tries to be a good mom, but the way she does, like with this Ronald, the way she brought her kids over there.
And that's the worst part of it.
It's really hard
not
to judge
her for it. She's not a stupid person.
That, you know what? That is it more than
anything. She's not a stupid person.
Danielle doesn't know any better because she's a dunce.
She's a dunce.
Tiffany is really fucking smart.
She's not a stupid person.
She's really, she's like.
And she has emotional intelligence,
too. She has a lot of emotional intelligence. She's a go-getter. She, like, knows how to make money. And she's just with
a fucking
loser of a man.
But it's these patterns that bring her back around to this awful, misogynist, toxic man.
Which, y'all, spoiler alert. I don't know if it's confirmed. Is it confirmed they're back together, or are we just pretty sure?
I saw something on Screen Rant. The only world's tested 90 Day Fiancé news source.
Hey, they rated us best one of the top 10 best podcasts of 2020.
Exhibit A.
But no, they're better than some, than like Gary's 90 Day News Alert.
Or Stargasm.
Yeah, we're like, oh, did you vet this? I don't think you did. They actually do. So, but... we think they're back together.
But it's just...
And you could tell, when this starts, you could tell they're still into each other.
Totally. And the thing is, it's not built on why she is in with this guy is built on the same issues that have ruled her whole life.
Yeah.
It isn't about just that she's physically attracted to him. He represents something that she thinks she needs that's going to screw her in the end. And she can't. It's so frustrating. She can't fucking see it.
Now, and we know she's not close or doesn't know her own father very well.
No, it's daddy issues.
No. She did reconcile with her dad. Remember?
Yeah, in the last season. But
she does have, like she said, like she's got some daddy. She's very close to her mom. I'm sure we'll see mom. Mom hates Ronald.
Yeah.
So I bet she's very excited about this.
And
she looks great. She's
she had
always,
weight loss surgery.
Y'all, she's always beautiful. And, you know, I said that.
Makeup's always on point.
I said that Kara has the best makeup in 90 Day. I kind of forgot about Tiffany when I said that because Tiffany's makeup is always.
Always. That's what she does.
Yeah. She's a pretty fucking phenomenal makeup artist. So she looks beautiful. She looked beautiful. I thought when she was at a different weight, she looks just as beautiful now. But it's she's been on a lot of you followed her. She had weight loss surgery. So she's just. Feeling
75
herself.
Pounds. Yeah. And Ronald.
Been single for 6 months.
And Ronald is constantly texting her now to get back together, she says, because of course he is.
Of course, because he's a loser.
I know she has regrets, and I feel that for her, but the idea that she made that man Daniel's father and created that bond.
I know.
It's just, and when she said, so unfortunately, we have to talk to Ronald every day. I'm like, that's on you?
And Tiffany says, you know, he was a crappy husband and didn't get his stuff together, but he's a wonderful father. And I went,
that's not true.
Is he? Because part of being a wonderful father is owning your shit and being responsible. Now, she didn't know he had a gambling addiction.
She did not know. So, he told her after the
but
fact.
But I feel like that's the least of... That's the least problematic thing about Ronald.
And if you guys, if this is the first time you've watched them together, or if you none of this will make sense if you haven't seen earlier when he's trying to do good things, she is constantly there to remind him of all
what
the
fuck up he is,
of what a fuck up he is. Because that's what she needs in a relationship. She needs to date trash bags.
So she
can tell them everything they're doing wrong.
She does need that. She does need that. Yeah.
She needs to date human trash bags so she could you smell bad.
Yeah, you're right.
You're misshapen. That's what she needs to feel validated.
Now, they applied for a visa, and his visa was denied, right?
I think that's not on this show, but you're saying that.
Wasn't not on this episode, but I think that happened in the past, right?
I think so because of his criminal record.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yo, Ronald's a real piece of work.
It's going to be hard to get him. America don't want him.
And I will say, Ronald is one of those 90 Day Fiancé men that scares the shit out of me.
Yeah.
There's something about him that in any moment I'll think he could just like cold cock her.
Yeah.
And there's an energy he has that I just find him so fucking scary. Yeah.
I don't love him.
Yeah, it's just.
Yeah, he
big old potato
he
head.
He triggers both of us.
Yeah, there's just. And
we don't talk about this character a lot, but like he gives me like Jeffrey vibes.
Yes.
Like,
yes.
Yeah.
It's that.
But Who knows?
But y'all, it's all good now because, y'all, she's going out. Ronald's talking to her. And I wrote on, Carly is so big.
She is. And she was cute the way she was talking. Daniel. Oh, Daniel. We love Daniel.
Oh, I'm so worried about Daniel.
I still said it. Poodle doesn't like when I say this, y'all. But straight, gay, whatever. I still think Daniel's going to end up dancing on that pole somewhere.
Working out his own trauma.
Working out. Hey, won't matter. A 20's a 20 and he's working it out.
You either work it out in the hole or on the pole.
Exactly. Exactly. Amen. Oh, I meant this one. Oh, wait, no, I meant this one. Yeah, that's
yes,
what I meant.
There you go. One or the other.
One or the, what is this one? Oh, I forgot about that one.
It's like sex music. So, they basically, it's a nice way to come into it.
Oh, okay.
So he's like, since when do you dress like this going out on a date? You know, to her, always needling her. And normally she says, what do you mean? I'm fine with how I look. What are you saying? I can dress however I want to. So they need
you look
this.
Nice. That's what they fight. And he's like, you look nice. And she goes, and that's all she wanted to hear from him. And she just kind of purses her mouth and she goes, thank you. She does.
They drive me up the wall.
She is a punisher.
Yes. The whole, she needs to do it.
Yeah.
And until she can find a reason why she's doing that, and it honestly just needs to be a way to deal with her anger. She needs to be in therapy with someone who needs to help her. Because all comes from just misplaced anger.
Yeah, I bet just from the little bit we've seen of her mother, I bet her mother did that to her own dad. It was probably rough. Her mother's probably very angry.
Yep.
And so it's just what she saw is that
she needs a trash bag.
Men are. I have a friend like this. Her mother was in relationship and talked about how shitty men are. And it's very hard for her to be in even a good relationship with a guy and not point out his flaws.
Yeah, if y'all are angry like
men
that.
Men do it too.
Yeah.
Men do it too. I've just.
But if you're angry, get some help with that because it'll just follow you your whole life.
Anger's great. It can lead you to a place It can lead you to decisions. It can lead you to self-worth and independence. So, but it's not good all the time.
Constant anger.
And it's just constant with her. It's just simmering.
Yeah. So she says, but this relationship, when he says, you look good. And he's like, thank you. She said, thank you. And I'm like, this is why it's so toxic. And this is why it's a pattern for them. And her friends, Brooke
and Fauna.
And Fauna.
That's a pretty name. Fauna. That's how you say
Fauna.
It.
They're going out for dates and some male strippers.
I think this is a great idea for her.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying this because y'all know.
You love strippers.
I love strippers. I would be in heaven.
So she's like, Tiffy's waking up. And the producer's like, who? She's like, that's my hoo-ha.
That's what call my is Tiffy.
Hello. It's your girl, Tiffy.
Yeah. I see some dick.
We've all. What do you call your, do you call it? Do you have a name for any of this
I don't.
Stuff? I don't either.
I don't.
I think you just call your ass enter here. The dump. Receptacle.
Plato's closet.
The black hole.
So basically, this is the other thing.
What
y'all.
Are those little things you put a coin in? Like that'd be at First National Bank when they're trying to get people to donate money and you put a coin in it. And then the penny just goes around in a circle for a and it goes.
I love those.
Boom, and then it gets closer. The other goes. Boom, 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 boom.
Ka-chink.
Whatever that's called, that's your butthole.
True. A big coin funnel.
Yes. There we are.
So y'all, she keeps saying, "I know one day my dream man is out there." Blah blah blah. It's long, long red hair like Sam Heughan from Outlander. Girl, same. He is so hot to me. So I
think I would really get into Outlander.
It is the ultimate, like, dream show for men because, like,
it makes women fucking wet.
Because honestly, it has every element that women love, but, like, it is so fantastical in its scope. And
you
know
who loves that show?
Bridget Green.
Oh, Bridget Green loves. Oh, she keeps asking me, can we cover it? Can you talk about Outlander?
It is so good.
But I will say why I think this is good is because this is, honestly, stick with me. Some people might agree, but I think it's actually a safe way for Tiffany to feel a little sexual in a safe space.
She means stripping?
She's with the strippers. They know that nothing's going to happen. It's just kind of good fun. She's with her friends. But probably...
I think it's fine.
I imagine she also probably feels... She has a different body.
Yeah.
So she probably feels very different about her sexuality. Yeah.
She's
and
freaked out probably, true.
This is good. Tiffany, more strip clubs for Tiffs.
So... She's on all the apps, but she's been talking to one guy, Fabian.
Yes, they're talking at a diner app.
I don't think it's the heartthrob in the 60s, Fabian.
No. But I do love this is my perfect night, y'all. You go see strippers, and then you have sweet potato fries at a diner.
And French toast.
Sounds good to me.
Why is it always so bright in diners? It's always like, it always hurts your eyes.
Have you seen the kind of people that go into a diner at 2 in the morning? They want to make sure you're not shifty. Or you
I guess. So she shows a picture of him. He's from New Jersey. He's Colombian and Mexican. And he's got long hair. And I was like, this is not what I expected from her.
Not what I expected at all. And his name's Fabian. They meet.
He's a hairdresser.
They had had sex before.
And they dated. Yeah.
And Tiffany says.
7 years ago.
Yes. She said there's a lot of spiciness because she said, I'm half Cuban, half Colombian. He's half Colombian, I think Mexican. Half Mexican. So she said, so we're bringing like Latin spice.
That's a combustible combination.
I will say, though, I felt like they had no chemistry. I didn't feel like it.
I feel like he wanted to fuck her.
Yes.
I don't think she felt it.
But it felt like so, not forced on his part, but just so, it was a lot.
No, he's doing this to promote his business.
Maybe it felt like a lot to me. I know maybe when a man's a little more aggressive, you respond well to that.
Oh, yeah.
Where I get a little...
Oh, and they're asking me their hotel room. I'm like, thank you for getting to business. Thank you for saving us the trouble. I'd rather not dance around this. So they're talking about kissing. He just gets right to it. You were a good kisser. Blah, blah, blah.
She's like, yeah, you were
y'all,
good too.
He is sending her all of the signals that...
He's looking at her tits.
Yeah, boy.
She looks beautiful. He's like, oh, you're wearing my favorite color. And I went, it's blue.
Like, now, I will say, he's dancing with her, and she's out of her comfort zone, but she's starting to enjoy it.
Yeah.
It looks like it. And then she's like lap dancing her. And he's like, I have a proposition for you. Would you like to go to my hotel? And she kind of looks wise. Do you think she's going to go?
No.
I don't think she will either.
I don't think
she's into him.
I don't think she's into him. I also think because it's on television, I don't think she's a little more self-conscious about that. I don't think she would do it. Because also, sadly, I think the main reason she won't do it is she knows Ronald would see this and freak out. And she would have
because
to deal with Ronald.
Still, y'all, even though she's acting like that she hates Ronald now, it's this thing. She's not done with him. She's not done with him.
She even says at the end of this, she said, I'm still thinking a little bit about like what Ronald would think about this.
And part of her, and this is one of the, a lot of times with when people in relationships, they look at saying, well, I failed. I must have done something wrong. So I think part of her still thinks if she lets Ronald go completely, she's a failure.
Yeah.
And that's how hard or how unreasonably difficult Tiffany is on herself.
Because we've said this before, Tiffany deals with the perfection monster.
Oh, yeah.
Big time. Big time.
Trust me, you spot it, you got it, as you say.
Yeah, that's true.
But
that's true.
Hell, she's just, she really is one of the worst decision makers in all 90 Day Fiancé.
She makes bad decisions.
She says, I'm done with Ronald. It'll be in the next season. It's like, so I took Ronald back, and now we're going to South Africa for 5 months for Christmas.
I'm done with Ronald. We were broken up. We moved back to South Africa. We moved from South Africa. Cut to next season. We're back together.
Yep. Always.
So it is this.
It's very frustrating.
It's going to be very hard for Daniel to... Yeah. Talk about someone who's going to have abandonment issues.
And think about this. He'll never, unless she's with him, maybe he'll get old enough that he'll be able to visit his dad. But, because, y'all, he calls him dad.
No.
We're not playing around if you don't know this. It's not like, oh, this is the guy I called dad, like my stepdad.
No, it is
he
dad.
He calls him dad.
Because she, when she had surprise baby, she told the father, and the father didn't want to have anything. So Daniel's right. never known his father,
no.
full stop.
Yeah.
I can't imagine that.
What?
Try not to judge someone, but I can't imagine knowing that someone said, I have a baby, and I just say, okay, go have good luck.
I don't think he was the most together of people. He was, like, shot.
You know what, though? Who knows? It could have been a blessing at all.
Right.
Yeah. Again, I'm not judging. It's
anyway,
sometimes the best thing to do is
every
to say
time,
no.
Every time a Tiffany Ronald segment comes along, y'all know that you're going to be forced to just sit through, like, a dinner full of, like, heavy root vegetables. It's never an easy time when
no.
Tiffany is on your screens.
But
trust
I will
me.
Say, they're going to have good fights, and the fights are always interesting because, well, interesting, but also sad because Ronald plays unfair.
He does.
He goes for the jugular.
God, he's so scary. I
can stomach them more when they're not together. It's
the
when
last,
they're in the same space.
I agree. The last Happily Ever After, oh. I celebrated when they would be, I said, hopefully it's the last time I'll see either of their fucking faces on this screen.
No, because I bet you they're going to get back together and be on Happily Ever After again.
No!
I bet they will. Because their first one was on The Other Way, right? No.
Yeah.
Or were they 90
They
day?
Were The Other Way.
They were The Other Way, yeah. First season, I think, right?
Were they?
I don't even remember. God, we watched so much shit.
No, they had to be Other Way.
All right.
Weren't they?
I don't know.
Because he's never been to the U.S.
People will leave comments. Yeah, I think it's the other. Pardon me, hiccup.
Or it's before. I bet they're B90.
Are they B90?
No one gives a shit.
I guess it is because the goal was for her to get him over here.
Yeah, I think they're B90.
I think they're B90. Yeah, Darcy. That's Darcy and Jesse. That feels familiar.
Yeah.
All right. Let's do this.
Let's talk about some madness. This is really the only fun storyline.
Yes.
Because Natalie's has turned into tragedy, sadly.
Yeah.
And Tanya's is just messy.
Tanya's is messy. And, you know,
Tiffany's is going to be a car crash.
And I went, oh, Josh dodged a bullet. And then we see next week he's taking her to meet his family. I went, I can't help you. I can't help you.
No, he deserves what he gets by now.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, now we're just fucking with Natalie.
God, I want to see his dick.
I don't think we'll get to see it.
We're
he's not the kind.
No, he's not the kind.
Unfortunately.
God, he's hot.
He is really hot to me.
Real. I want him to dye his hair less dark. But yeah. Other than that, he's real
that
hot.
That body, God, I would
curvy.
Climb that like a
oh
redwood.
Oh, my God. We both need to get it done.
I know.
All right, let's talk about Caesar.
It's the
he's
day
trying to get it done.
It's the day after the meet and greet, and his first date is tonight, and Caesar calls Katarina, and he's like,
because I'm shocked. Caesar reads the Washington Post. He's scrolling at news, and I went, Caesar reads... I really thought Caesar was a USA Today guy.
He loves the opinions.
I mean, were you not shocked that he reads the Post?
I think he skims. I don't...
This is going to be interesting because he's reading the news, and he's saying, y'all remember, this is December. December of last year.
Right.
Things were really like coming. The war starting in February. So this is like getting...
Russia was kind of surrounding Ukraine at that
and
point.
But it's interesting because... So we're not on the same time. So he's December, but... yeah, okay.
They're all different timelines.
They're all different time. And so... But... So they're... He's reading the news. And it's going to be interesting because Katarina is like...
She's like, oh, Caesar, it's not as difficult as you hear. Everything's fine. Where's my money?
Here's the deal, though. The camera crew's there, and they've got insurance. They've got liability. So they could very well pull out and stop. Caesar could stay if he wanted to, but they might have to pull out and stop filming.
That is true.
I think we'll get all of his season, though, because the war doesn't start till February. I'm sure they're going to be able to be there all of Christmas. And
no, I don't think... I think he's coming back for that.
Yeah, I think they'll get everything
I think
they
his
need.
Story... His storyline probably has the tightest window.
All of his probably happened in, like, 2 weeks.
Yeah. And Wyla is probably, like, Debbie's probably took months to film.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
You would hope. So, yeah, she's like, it's not that bad here, which I think you talked about. That was a sentiment by some people in Europe.
A lot of people, yeah.
A lot of people thought that news outlets were just making more of a big deal of it.
Well, I think Russia does this so many times. It's kind of like playing chicken.
Yeah.
You know, and but this was because there hasn't been a country that has basically invaded the sovereignty of another since World War II.
Yeah.
You know.
So it just seems like this can't happen anymore.
Right.
It's kind of Yara's on 90 Days experience of this cannot be happening this day and age.
And there were some like blurred lines of in the Soviet republics where that was happening, but like this was a sovereign country. So, yeah,
Open, read the news.
Awful.
Look at what's going on in the world. Maybe don't read the news.
The world's a scary place.
It's a scary place right now.
But I would say, what I would tell you is be informed. Don't let it overwhelm you.
Yeah, that's true.
I get super overwhelmed. I can read the news and then I watch an episode of America's Test Kitchen or Great British Baking Show.
Yeah, that's a good way to do it. Because you want to be informed. Yeah, I'll read it. If I watch TV news, it's too much for me.
I have to choose the news I watch.
Yeah, yeah. Again, Caesar reads the Washington Post. I'm shook.
So, y'all, there are three dates. Valentina, the one who was obsessed with his hat mm-hmm. and who called him a fish, a Pisces.
Yes, and then Katarina.
The one who was the nail tech. The gorgeous one.
Yes.
And then Alona, who was into the fitness, into sport.
Oh, my thing corrected to alone.
How do I get you alone? How do I get alone? Alone.
Again, the heart version's wonderful. And so is the Celine Dion version.
Yes.
God.
Have you ever heard Kelly Clarkson sing it?
I think I have a long time
Unbelievable.
Ago.
Unbelievable.
What did she just sing on Kelly-Oki that was so fucking good?
You still watch her show?
I do like her talk show. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
People seem to like it.
I don't watch every day.
Yeah.
But I'll watch, like, she just did a great interview with her and Rosie O'Donnell.
I don't think there's anyone who doesn't like her.
Kelly? Oh, no, I agree. Everybody likes her. I thought
maybe
you were
going to
say Rosie O'Donnell. I was like, I don't think a lot of people like her.
Maybe her ex-husband.
I love Rosie O'Donnell, though. But yes, I don't think her ex-boyfriend, Brandon Blackwell, is a good fan.
Black Stock,
yes.
Yeah.
Brandon Blackwell's a guy I went to high school with.
I knew it had to be, because you remember them like they're your neighbors.
His family had a ranch. I remember I always wanted to go and ride horses.
Did you get to?
No.
Because you're a faggot?
Yeah. we were really friends.
That's the reason why we couldn't do a lot of things.
It's true.
Because we were gee. We weren't allowed to be with the boys.
I remember his ass when he wore Wrangler. So that was a time in middle school and I went, I shouldn't be thinking this, but I am. I am.
Wow. Stop. So he's got his Russian for Dummies and he's saying, I'm so glad they got him to do this. And he's like, it's perfect. He's like some blah, blah, blah in Russian. And the cameraman's like, that's not Russian. It's Chinese.
It's Chinese. It's terrible. It was great. I bet that Caesar's probably one of their most favorite people to film with.
I
think Caesar's a good time.
He's a good guy.
I think he's a good guy. He's a good time. And I will say,
he only just wants to fuck blonde, blow-up doll women, unfortunately. But
yet, that is what he thinks love is.
I know.
In a weird way.
That's his
version of love. And so, I have to say, he goes on this first date with Valentina.
Y'all, this hair is crisis hair.
Her hair's bad.
It is nuts.
It needs a hot oil treatment stat.
She's kind of looks like she's in Dairy Girls, that show.
Yes. And I think there is a better way to do this. I think this is the best encapsulated with a Reality Gay Single Life
Single
Theater.
Life Edition. Ukrainian Edition.
Ukrainian Edition.
Is that
Ukrainian or Russian? I don't know.
That was nonsense syllables.
Okay, well...
You think I know Ukrainian,
you know,
or Russian?
You fucked a lot of people. Have you ever fucked? You fucked a Russian, right?
Yes.
Wow, your eyes got big
violent.
On that. Never Ukrainian?
I don't think so.
Well,
I don't think so. I've drank with a lot of them because a lot of them were either violinists or pianists. A lot of Ukrainian string players that I went to school with.
Mm-hmm.
They can put it down.
All right. So Poodle's going to be playing Caesar. I'm going to be playing Valentina. And action.
Hello. It's so good to see you.
Hello. Here, I brought you a present. I brought you a present.
Oh,
it's chocolate.
I love presents.
It's like your skin.
That's chocolate. That's something to say. That's weird.
Chocolate. That's appropriate.
That's a little weird.
Not weird to say at all. Yes. Yes. Oh,
so,
I notices you right away, Caesar.
I like the way you pronounce my name.
Thank you. Thank you. You're interesting dressed. Yes. How are you?
I'm good. You know, it's an interesting country here.
What would you like for dinner? What would you like for
dinner? Why don't you pick for me? Just pick something for
me. I want a man who takes me.
No.
Okay.
Pick something for me. It's whatever you want.
He'll have fish.
No, not fish.
What?
No, not fish.
You don't want fish?
No, that's not. I felt fish all the time.
I'm
fish all the time.
Okay, do you want to have pork?
Pork dinner. Sounds good.
Okay.
That's good.
Listen,
Michelle fixes a really good pork dinner.
Let's just go with it.
Anything
you want to ask me? Ask me. I'm here.
I just want to know. You have a good time?
Yeah, have a good time. Have a good time. I'm getting over.
Do you want kids?
Yes.
I kind of want to be a father.
Katarina told me to say yes, so I say yes.
Two little girls. Two little girls sounds good to me.
Yes, it's fine. Do you know what broken heart is?
I do. A woman, you know what, broken heart for me.
Do you know where broken hearts goes?
Will they find their way home? After they open up, is there a love that's waiting there?
Yes.
And if somebody loves you, will they always love you? Look at your eyes. Is there love that's waiting there? For me. Well, yeah.
See? That went a totally different way I expected it to go.
So,
but I enjoyed it.
It was weird.
We find out she was married and, or she was dating this guy and she found out he was married and had two children. And she said, it's not very difficult to believe men's.
He also says, he's like, do you know why I came to you? Your eyes and you fish.
And you fish, yes, you fish.
The other thing.
I didn't get to that because the song threw me off.
My other favorite thing she said was, she just says, my desire to start a family is very strong. And she says, do you want to live here or the U.S.? He's like, I'd basically like to go back there. She's like, so. I will hope you come back to Ukraine again, and we will speak about our future.
And we'll speak about our future.
So then we will decide to get married or not.
But there's the one part where I'm going to say this. Caesar was flirting, and he was flirting somewhat well. Like, he took her hand. She's like, tell me. And he, like, silly reads
palm reading.
Palm. And he says, like, you will have 20 children. He makes a joke.
Yeah.
She gets it, and I went, my God, Caesar is flirting and being
it's
charming.
No, but it's like weird 20-year-old flirting,
but
though.
When you have a little bit of the lost, the translation thing that they're learning, it works. I see why he doesn't work in the U.S., but when someone thinks he, when they don't have a full grasp of English, it seems funny.
If you don't speak English well,
yes,
Caesar's a guy for you.
Caesar's a guy for you.
That should be his slogan.
This is a match already. I think Caesar found love.
Good.
Do you think this one's going to work out?
Absolutely not. And the other two are going to be goose eggs, too. So, because y'all, we're going to have to watch him be sad. I don't know why he does. He mentioned, the only thing I think of is he mentioned he might get back with the woman the sister of the guy who took him to the airport. Because he dated her. That was an Easter egg. I think they did.
It's an Easter egg?
I think they mentioned that for a reason.
Well, sorry. Excuse me. I have puberty there.
You as a boy.
We'll see. We'll see. Maybe.
That's the show.
I kind of want him to get with someone from Ukraine or Russia that just takes advantage of him because that's
fun to
watch. Of course,
because that's more fun to watch.
Y'all, that is a show. That is a single life. This, again, y'all, there has not been a dud episode of the season.
Agree.
It's a good one, y'all. So if you're just listening to us, that's great. But if you're not watching it, we're telling you, it good. All right, everybody.
It good.
Go to our website because you can go there now to realitygaze.com.
It's not poor anymore.
I fixed the other one, the old Dear Maddie one, too. That was hacked, too. So now you can listen to old Dear Maddie episodes.
Wow.
If you want. There's the ones with Jake and I. So go to the website. On there, you can leave an Apple or a podcast or a Spotify review and go to our Linktree link. That's still on. It's not on the website yet, but I just figured that out with Patrick with the cute butt yesterday. So go to our Linktree link in the show notes or on that link on our Instagram or TikTok, and you can find all of that information to buy tickets to the Double It Tour. There are still tickets available. We would love to see you next week. We leave in three days.
All right, so much to do before then.
All right, everybody. We call these people lonely hearts because aren't we all just lonely hearts looking for love in all the wrong places, poods?
Yes. And if you've ever known a broken heart and you want to know where they go, who sang that?
You're kidding. Broken hearts go when they find their
Winnie,
way
Winnie,
home.
Winnie.
Yes.
Sorry.
And as a body love, don't they always love you? I look in your eyes and I know that you still care for me.
Ooh. You ain't do whatever you want. Call us.
Okay, for me.
Okay, I'm ending this. Bye.